الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الكريم الوهاب الرحيم التواب غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب بالقول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الأحباب، أيتها الأخوات الكريمات، أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في عليائه أن ينضر هذه الوجوه المتواضعه، وأسأله عز وجل كما جمعنا في هذه الدنيا في هذا المسجد المبارك أن يجمعني وإياكم في مستقر رحمته تحت ظل عرشه، يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. اللهم آمين، آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters in Islam, we should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, as He should be feared. I testify that there is no God but Allah, only one God, Creator. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. Dear brothers, dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, is showering all of us with too many of His bounties and favors and the ni'am 24/7, even if we are not asking Him, He's still giving us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that's why one of the conditions of al-Iman and qimmat al-Iman and the top of your Iman to be gratitude and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to see athar al-ni'mah ala 'abdih. Athar al-ni'mah, He loves to see that favor or that ni'mah He gave it to you on you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your tongue, to say alhamdulillah wa shukri lillah bil lisan wa thana bil qalb wal mahabba, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your heart also, and to practice this and to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gratitude practically. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ, remember me, I will remember you. And it's a big ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you. Who am I that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention my name there above His seven heavens and above the arsh amongst His great angels? Allahu Akbar. فَذْكُرُونِي, remember me through salah, with dhikr al-Qur'an, with coming to the masjid. I will remember you. I will be proud of you. وَشْكُرُونِي, be grateful to me, gratitude, thankful to me. ولا تكفرون, do not deny my ni'mah, don't be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
He mentioned in the Holy Quran some of his prophets and messengers, and they were the best of his servants and slaves, the Anbiya and the messengers of Allah. For example, Sayyidina Ibrahim, when he described, when he gave us some of his attributes to us, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, what did he say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ اجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ. He was very grateful to Allah's ni'mah, to Allah's bounties and favors, and he being chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was مُجْتَبَى, اجْتَبَاهُ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him to وَهَدَاهُ إِلَى الصِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, to the straight way, to the straight path, subhanallah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also talks about Prophet Noah, he said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Indeed, he was one of our servants who was very grateful to us, subhanallah. This sound good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking highly about the prophets and messengers. إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا اجْتَبَاهُ شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ. What about our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He used to stand at night praying, his foot swollen, tears, crying. تسمع لصدره أزيز كأزيز المرجل. According to the hadith, if you stand beside him while he was praying at night sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Prophet Muhammad, you hear that sound like the boiling oil, Aziz al-Mirjal, subhanallah. Out of the fear and khashya and the khushu' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aisha, his wife, our mother, may Allah be pleased with her. Ya Rasulullah, didn't Allah forgive your sin? You've been forgiven already. And he said to her, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. I would love to be grateful to my God. أَلَمْ أَكُنْ يَتِيمًا فَآوَانِي. I was orphaned, he gave me shelter. وَفَقِيرًا فَأَغْنَانِي. I was poor and he enriched me. وَضَالًّا فَهَدَانِي. I did not know nothing about Islam, he gave me Islam. This is the meaning of وَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. Somebody can say وَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَقْفَ الرَّبِينَ مِسْجَادٍ. No, the meaning of this ayah, that he was not aware about Islam. Allah sent Jibreel alayhi salam and he told him the message, the revelation. This is the meaning of the ayah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah never did any mistake even when, before he became a prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who are few from my servants, those who are grateful to me. وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. اعملوا, that ayah related to the family of David. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave King David, Dawood, the kingdom and the nubuwa, prophethood. David and his son Solomon. Subhanallah. That's why Allah said, اعملوا. آل داود شكرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Sayyidina Dawood and his family, his relatives, and his followers too. Al-al means followers. أدخلوا آل فرعون أشد العذاب. يعني Pharaoh and his followers, not his family. No, Asia, she was his wife. See? And when you say آل بيت النبي, some مفسرين, they said آل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, his followers. You are one of the آل بيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Any follower to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's from his آل. According to آيات of the Quran. Some مفسرين, they said آل بيت النبي, طبعا آل جعفر وكذا, علي and العباس, and this is some different meaning too. And Allah said, وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Allah is telling Prophet Dawood, I want to see your gratitude to me practically. Work. اعملوا عمل. And a few of my servants, they are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, I give you to many of my bounties, countless. وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. إن هنا في اللغة العربية عند جرامر للشك. للشك. Yeah, if you try. And Allah said, you will be in doubt too. If you try to count Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings, it's countless, you cannot. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you seek extra, you're healthy, you have knowledge, you have children, you have power, you have position, you have, mashallah, Allah's giving you too many things. If you need extras, what should you do? وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَئِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. If you will be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need extra, Allah will give you if you will be grateful to Allah. But if you deny, you will be ungrateful to Allah. Means you can, if you are using or misusing Allah's ni'mah, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, my azab, my punishment is severe. Yes, that's why. And all those who are getting benefits from the ayatullah. When I say ayatullah, I know all of you, your mind is going to the verses of the Holy Quran. But ayatullah has three meanings in the Holy Quran. First is al-ayat al-kawniyah. Al-ayat al-kawniyah means that the heaven, the earth, the sun, the moon, the alternation of the day and night, all of these ayat kawniyah, this universe, who did create it? Allah. Second type of the meaning of al-ayat, also the miracles, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to his messengers and prophets. الملك, the, everything and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creature, like the heaven and the earth, in Allah's dominion and universe, in certain law. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made it in a certain system. But the miracles of Allah is against the system. Against the system. Did you see in your life somebody get a pregnant she camel from Iraq? Yes, it's happened once. When people, they ask, challenge the Prophet Saleh, and they said, if you bring from this big rock in the desert, that rock, it was in the middle of the desert, alone like this, big, huge. You know that big rock in the desert? Nothing around it. We need a pregnant she camel. If you bring it, we're going to follow you. He said, I will ask Allah. Allah brought it to them. What happened? You know the story from the Quran. They killed it. فَتَعَاطَ فَعَقَرَ. They slaughtered it. And Allah punished them all because of that. Why? Because they ask it for a miracle and they are denying it. That's why if you ask for miracles and you deny it, this is a big problem. The people of Mecca, they asked Rasulullah for miracles. The split of the moon, for example, too many, and they deny it. And what happened to them? Did Allah punish them? No. Do you know why? Because Rasulullah was amongst them. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. Because of you, otherwise, I will finish them like the people of Lot and people of Salih and people of Hud. See Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمانة لأصحابه. Allah secured all of the area in Arabia, including the kuffar, because Rasulullah was amongst them. Because of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. If you ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah will never gonna punish you. This is what the Quran said. That's why, subhanallah, this is second type of ayat. The third type of ayat, the verses of the Holy Quran. Now when you read this ayat, ayati, ayatullah, you have that three meanings must hit your mind. Al-ayat al-kawniyah, this universe, it's an open book for you. Look to the sun, to the moon. Did you see any crack in the sky? Subhanallah said, فَمَنْ فَرْجِعِ الْبَصَرِ هَلْ تَرَى مِنْ فُطُورِ ثُمَّ ارْجِعِ الْبَصَرِ انْقَلِبْ إِلَيْكَ الْبَصَرُ فَسَيْنُ وَحَسِيرِ. See, this is ayatullah al-kawniyah, الكتاب المفتوح, it's open book. And that's the open book, which is this universe. And you take the sabak, the ibra, the lesson. Look at the book, which is the verses of the Holy Quran. They are connected. And the miracles, there is no miracles after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like, it was a miracle, brother. There is no miracle, brother. It's, you can say karama. Karama, I can accept it. But no miracle after Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, this is the meaning. Those who are getting benefits of the ayat of Allah, those who are grateful to Allah. Who said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إن في ذلك لآيات لكل صبار شكور. Those who are patient, those who are gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وكان من دعائه صلى الله عليه وسلم, some of his du'as عليه الصلاة والسلام, رب اجعلني لك ذكارا. Oh my Lord, make me ذكارا amongst those who are remembering you. شكارا, make me amongst those who are grateful to you. Ya Rahaba, those who are, that they have the fear. Mitwa'a, make me amongst those who are obedient to you. Mukhbitan ilayka awwaha al-muniba. This beautiful dua. Ask Allah all the time to make you and me amongst those who are grateful to Allah. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who are humble, those who are obeying Allah azza wa jal, those who are, when they make sin, they come back to Allah. Raja', he'll turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, brothers and sisters, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed on you الإيمان. You have إيمان in your heart. Too many people they don't have إيمان. You have it. If Allah chose you to come to His masjid, you are different. Allah, I all the time in my lecture I tell the brothers like this. Brothers, think about it. There are too many. Even Muslims, they never come to the masjid, but Allah opened His door for you. And I cannot invite you to my house where I don't like you. Imagine Allah Azza wa Jal, He's opening His doors for you and you come and He's welcoming you. Means you are special. You are coming to His house. He invites you. Even in general, in this universe, if I ask you, did Allah create the man first or the earth? He created the earth first, right? Before He created Adam, He created this earth. And He settled everything in it. The water, the animals, everything in it, subhanAllah. And then He invites you, come to my land, come to my house, live in it for a short time, and you're going to come back to me. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He invites you to His house, you are different. You are not like anybody. He loves you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why if you have that iman, you have the Quran, you have the knowledge, you have the sunnah, you know the sunnah, you are healthy, you have some times to come to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فأنت في نعمة تستوجب الشكر. Allah is showering you with lots of His blessings and you must be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith said, من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه عنده قوت يومه معافا في جسده فقد حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها. Brothers, sisters, when you wake up every morning, healthy, healthy, being secured in your community, alhamdulillah. Not just that, you have food only for one day. Do you have food for one day? We have food for years after our death. Wallahi, see some brothers, they have trillions. That trillion, nobody, he gonna die before even he gonna look at it. If he try to count it, he will count it until he will die. And he will not finish. And this is the dunya. We are really behind. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab was blaming his son Abdullah. And Abdullah ibn Umar, one of the four Abdullahs, they used to mention the hadith of Rasulullah. Abdullah was rich, he was a businessman. Abdullah, the son of Umar ibn al-Khattab. He used to love to eat fish. You know, he used to live in Medina. There is no oceans around in Medina. He used to look for fish for 4 days, 5 days until somebody brought fish for him. Nowadays you can get it from Amazon. Subhanallah. Yeah. Subhanallah. Abdullah was looking for almost 1 week to eat fish. He used to love sugar so much. He used to love grapes, to eat grapes so much. And he used to get it all. And Sayyidina Umar used to say him, Ya Abdullah, أَوَكُلَّمَ اشْتَهَيْتَ اشْتَرَيْتَ Everything you're desiring it. You buy it? Huh? Look at our kids nowadays. See Amazon people, they're coming to your house 24/7. Boxes every day, right? Subhanallah. أَوَكُلَّمَ اشْتَهَيْتَ اشْتَرَيْتَ More you desire, more you get it. What is this? Some control? لا إله إلا الله. But that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ni'am. Allah, He said, if you have food just only one day, for one day, you have dunya in your bucket. This world in your bucket. فَقَدْ حِيزَتْ لَكَ الدُّنْيَا بِحَزَافِرِهَا Brothers, look at somebody who's less than you in money or whatever and say, Alhamdulillah. Don't compare in dunya with somebody better than you. If you want to compare with somebody better than you, for the akhirah hereafter. Somebody praying fajr, you're not. Ask yourself, why? Is he better than me? Why am I not going to pray fajr with him? Somebody giving sadaqat and you're capable, you can give sadaqa. Why? Is he better than me? No, I will compete. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ Compete in this فعل الخيرات for the jannah. Dunya, don't worry. Because all of us, me and you are going to our grave one day. I'm not telling you just be zahid and no, do your job, do your work, alhamdulillah, enjoy your life. In the halal way, no problem, but don't make it dunya your mission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us wallahi even without questioning Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا Allah revealed this ayah twice in the Quran. One in Surah Ibrahim and one in Surah An-Nahl. And both, I can say, the Surah An-Na'am. The surahs of An-Na'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ In Surah Ibrahim, when Allah was talking about ni'mat al-Iman in Surah Ibrahim, the main column of Surah Ibrahim, chapter of Ibrahim, Allah is talking about ni'mat al-Iman. And He mentioned the father of the prophets, Prophet Ibrahim, in the Surah. And they said, if you try to count Allah's ni'am, it's countless. And the insan, he's all the time zalum, he's oppressing himself, and he's denying Allah's ni'am. In Surah Al-Nahl, Allah is talking about ni'am, ni'am al-dunya, whatever he bestowed you to eat, to drink, to live your life. In Surah Al-Nahl, وَالْخَيْلَ وَالْبِغَالَ وَالْحَمِيرَ لِتَرْكَبُوهَا الوقت اللي تأكلوها في ناس بتأكل حمير وزينة ويخلق ما لا تعلمون. Too many ni'ams Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in Surah Al-Nahl. And he mentioned the same ayah, but he ended with some different end. He said, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Indeed, Allah is still all forgiving, all merciful. Otherwise, he will take it away from you. Because of his forgiveness and mercy, even if you are disobeying him, even the kafir, he's still giving him. Because he is Rabbil Nas. Allah said, Rabbil Nas, he's the Lord of all mankind, even the kuffar. Even the kafir, Allah created him, and he will never gonna leave him in nowhere. Because he said, I am your creator. There is no creator for me except you. You have 10 kids in your house. MashaAllah, 8 of them, they are very good. And one of them bad. Are you gonna throw him in the street? He's still your son. What can you do? Subhanallah, al-masal al-a'la. Subhanallah. Those who are disobeying him, worshipping others beside him, he's still feeding them. Even he's giving them everything in this dunya. Why? Because he's a creator. He's the only creator, Rabbil Nas. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Juziyya rahimahullah قال منفعة الشكر ترجع إلى العبد في الدنيا والآخرة. أيوة. The benefits of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's coming back to you. If you worship Allah 24/7, you will never gonna benefit him. He is in nafa', the beneficent. If you disobey Allah 24/7, you will never gonna harm him. طيب, if you will be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, it's benefit, being gratitude and grateful, thankful to Allah, it's coming back to you. Who said? Allah. Look what Allah said in Surah Luqman. وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌ حَمِيدٌ. If you will be grateful to Allah, it's benefit, it's coming back to you. And they said also, وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ قال ومن كفر فإن ربي غني كريم. If you deny Allah, is my Rabb is غني, he's self sufficient, he's all generous سبحانه وتعالى. When you make shukr, this is إحسان, you make إحسان to yourself, it's going back to you سبحان الله. واشكروا لله. If you really worship Allah in reality, you have to be grateful to him. Who said? Allah. واشكروا لله, سورة البقرة. إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. If you worship Allah in reality, you have to be grateful to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. فلا يعبد الله حق عبادته إلا الشاكرون. Those who are grateful to Allah عز وجل. Allah said in Surah Az-Zumar, وإن تشكروا يرضه لكم. He will be so happy if you being appreciative and grateful to him. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى, there is somebody from the human being or the human, you have to be grateful to them after Allah عز وجل. Whom? Your parents. أن اشكر لي ولوالديك. Be grateful to me and your parents. وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا. Make إحسان to your parents during their life, even after their death. Make dua for them, make charity in their behalf. You can fast for them, praying, no. You can make hajj for them, you can make umrah for them, salah, no. Everything you can do it for them except the salah. Yeah, we have to know that. How to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? First of all, sujood al-shukr. If somebody give you ni'mah or give you good news, just bow, prostrate yourself to Allah. Make sajda al-shukr. All the time say alhamdulillah. Walhamdulillah yatamla'u al-mizan. Do you know what is, how big is it, the mizan of Allah? It's bigger than the seven heavens and seven earth. You say just alhamdulillah, the mizan will be full of hasanat, good deeds. Just you say alhamdulillah. One of the surah al-fatih has name, 11 names. One of its name, surah al-hamd. سوره الحمد. والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد افضل من الشكر, better than even الشكر. When you say الحمد لله, better than شكر لله. Why? Because الحمد عندها الف ولام. الف ولام دي بيسموها الاستغراق. الاستغراق يعني ايه؟ يعني the meaning all thanks and praises are due to Allah. الحمد, كل الحمد, all of الحمد, all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbil Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, be away from making sin. Don't sin. Don't make any sin. Be away. Because if you are sinning, you are disobeying Allah, Allah can take his ni'mah back from you. Yeah? إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيُحْرَمُ الرِّزْقَ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُهُ. Rasulullah said that. Because of your sin, Allah can deprive you. because of your sin. إن العبد another حديث لا يحرم تكبيرة الإحرام خلف الإمام. الإمام saying الله أكبر, you come during his ركوع. Because when you say الله أكبر, you come behind the imam, when saying الله أكبر, تكبيرة الإحرام الصلاة, the superiority is better, more far, more when you come during سجود or ركوع. سبحان الله. You're missing what about those who are missing the salah itself of they are away distance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الاستغفار, الصدقة, الحج, all of this. سيدنا سليمان, Allah gave him the kingdom and the نبوة. When somebody brought the throne of Bilqis from Yemen to Jerusalem to him, look what did he say. قال هذا من فضل ربي ليبلوني أشكر أم أكفر. Oh, all of this from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah is examining me. Am I gonna be grateful to him or ungrateful to him? When you see the arsh of Bilqis front of him, and less than when he blanked, وقال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم من مقامك. He said, the عفريت, one of the jinn, he said to Sayyidina Sulaiman, I will go Yemen, I will bring the arsh of Bilqis to you in Jerusalem before you finish your city, like from Dhuhr to Asr time. وقال الذي عنده علم من الكتاب, he was human, he was not jinn. But Allah gives him Allah's greatest name. آه ده اسم الله الأعظم. He just أنا أتيك به قبل أن يرتد إليك طرفك. Just when you blink your eyes, this, you will find it in front of you. سيدنا سليمان, when he found it, he said Allah سبحانه وتعالى examining me. When Allah gives you نعمة, money, anything like that, Allah is examining you. ليبلوكم فيما آتاكم. Why I take it from someone, I give it to you. Not because you are better than him, I'm examining you. And سيدنا سليمان said that الطاعم الشاكر بمنزلة الصائم الصابر. ده حديث حسن غريب ولكن the meaning is correct. سبحان الله. If you eat food and you say الحمد لله شكر لله, like somebody fasting while he's so patient, Allah will consider you like him. At least the minimum when you eat, say بسم الله الحمد لله. Allah will be appreciate that. سبحان الله. نعم. Brothers, why Allah سبحانه وتعالى, sisters, create us in this dunya? Allah did create us to make righteous good deeds. That's why when we die, we'll be in the grave. That one, he goes to Allah with lots of shortcomings in this a'mal, good deeds. He will say, رَبِّ رِجِعُونِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَتْرَكْتِ. Oh Allah, give me another chance. Give me respite. I want to make good deeds again. For Allah created us to make good deeds. And we've been created to make righteous good deeds. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. You want to keep this ni'mah? الله سبحانه وتعالى said ذلك بأن الله لم يكن مغيرا نعمة أنعمها على قوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. نعم, ما بأنفسهم. Brothers, be grateful to Allah. Change from being bad to good. Allah will give you more. Allah will give you نعم. Allah will make you healthy, happy. Allah will give barakah in your life, your kids, your family. والله, you're gonna live your life in Jannah before you go to Jannah, إن شاء الله رب العالمين. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوبون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروا. الحمد لله رب العالمين, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي المؤمنين, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers, dear sisters, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the end of long حديث قدسي, إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم, أحصيها لكم ثم أوفيكم إياها, فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله, ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن إلا نفسه. These are your deeds. Allah is counting for you. If you find something good, say Alhamdulillah. If you find something else, he said that something else. He did. Allah did not mention the bad word. He can say, فَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ, he said, وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. He can say, فَمَنْ وَجَدَ something bad. He did not say that. Something else. Even the about the bad deeds, he did not mention it. Allah. Something else. If you find something else, just blame yourself. فالحمدلله عز وجل على نعمة الإيجاد. Alhamdulillah, Allah the one who created us. والحمد لله على نعمة الإمداد. الحمد لله, Allah is still providing for us. والحمد لله على نعمة الهدى والرشاد. الحمد لله for the guidance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Dear brothers, dear sisters, use the ni'am of Allah in the way of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive all of us. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات. يا رب اجعلنا يا رب العالمين ممن يستجيب لدعوتك يا أرحم الراحمين, واحشرنا في دار المقامة ودار السلام يا رب العالمين. والله سبحانه وتعالى bring all of us يا أرحم الراحمين جنة الفردوس الأعلى the home of peace يا أرحم الراحمين دار السلام يا رب العالمين وأتم علينا بالسلام وارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا تقبل منا يا رب العالمين واجعلنا لك من الشاكرين يا أرحم الراحمين وانصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك كلمتي الحق والدين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وأقم الصلاة